Okay, so it is the morning of the last day here at Kavanaugh Bay. We are going to take off out of here, fly up to Sullivan, and then come back to Priest Lake here and kind of do a circuit around the north side of the lake, then come back here to Kavanaugh Bay to pack up and head home back to Washington. It's been super, super fun. It's beautiful here. You can see it's just this perfectly soft grass strip to land on. It's right on the lake over here. Can't recommend this place enough. It's super convenient. It had like 4 bars of cell phone, and there's restaurants and cafes right, you know, across the street if you want to do that instead of, you know, freeze-dried camp food or whatever. So got to see all kinds of cool planes come in here. We got like a Kodiak taking off over there this morning. We've had Turbo Commanders come in here, TBMs. You get to see it all, Kavanaugh Bay. So it's been super fun. Quick turnaround, just a couple nights. I wish I could stay longer, but I'm grateful to have gotten to see it and fly around the area. Northern Idaho is just incredibly beautiful, and we're gonna go see some more of it right now. Let's go.
Cav Bay, Yoka Mix 122 Alpha's taking 33 for departure. Over the lake. Airport is so cool. It is amazing to go into places like this. So few people and even fewer pilots get to experience places like this. It's so cool.
Jesse, you still up?
Yeah, both stay up until you're down.
Is that like a dirt track that's kind of running a diagonal? Is that mostly the runway or is it basically anywhere in that grass? I don't really see any cones from here yet.
There are white runway or landing area markers. Once you get closer, you'll see them in the center, lighter area of the runway.
Awesome, thanks.
I'm staying on frequency until she gets down, because if any animals or something runs out onto the runway last minute, I want to be able to tell her about it. What a thrill this is. I can't describe it.
Okay, just landed Sullivan Lake. It is an incredible spot. You have to descend over the mountains and kind of come in over the lake, and it's just beautiful. I am so glad that the fires didn't sock this in and make it impossible to land here, because there are valleys that are just completely covered in smoke from nearby forest fires right now. But huge grass strip, no wind at all. Well, maybe a little now. There's the windsock. If you're doing the Washington Passport Program, where you fly to like the airports that have these stamps, this is the kind of thing that will be by these airport signs, and this has got a guest book in it too. But you pull this out, and I think there's a stamp somewhere in here. Let's take a look. There's the stamp. I'm not going to give all the private information to people, but you pull that stamp out, and you stamp your passport, which I sadly do not have. I haven't gotten around to getting it, but go to the website, you'll find where you can get the passport and kick this off. But a super cool program, because you can get to have another reason to come to places like this if that isn't a reason enough. Also, make sure you sign the guest book, because I just found out that they use that for funding justification. So you come into any of these amazing places that have to be maintained by Department of Transportation and stuff, sign that guest book. Tell them you love it. I'll keep paying to maintain it. Okay, so this is Eckert. As far north in the U.S. as you can get. I think Canada is like across the berm over there. There's some kind of vineyard or some kind of, I don't know what that is, that they grow hanging vines like that, but it's cool. Of an amazing trip. I wish I could have been there for the entire like 11-12 days that they were out, but at least I got to check out some amazing spots in Idaho and Washington and get this thing out doing what it's built to do, which is get out to the backcountry. I'm smoked, wet, hungry, and it's still hot out here, so I'm gonna go clean up, get some food, and I will see you guys on the next flight. Later.